Hello, my dear students. I hope you all are doing well. So once again, welcome back to your geography class. In this class, I am going to teach you one of the major topics of your syllabus, class 11 ICC, that is sedimentary rock, the general characteristics and the economic importance. After this video, I am going to put some important and interesting questions. So I'll hope that you all will try to attend this. So without any further delay, let's move on to the topic. Now, we all know that according to the formation, the rocks are generally classified into three broad categories. What are they? Number one, that is igneous rock. Number two, that is sedimentary rock. Number three, that is metamorphic rock. Now, in this video, I am going to teach you the sedimentary rocks, the characteristics and the importance, that means the economic significance. So what is sedimentary rock? First of all, I want to tell you that sedimentary rock is not as much as important like igneous rock. Okay, igneous rock is the most important rock present on the earth's surface. But the 3/4 portion of our earth crust, it is covered by sedimentary rock. And sedimentary rock also shares 5% of the volume of the earth's crust. So yes, it is a valuable data. You need to keep it in your mind. Okay. Now sedimentary. By this name only, you can understand this. Sedimentary means by the sediments, this rock is going to form. Now what is the sediments? Through the process of exogenic agents like river, wind, glaciers, sea waves, what happened? The finer particles, this can be eroded away. And after that, the particles will be deposited at a particular place or at a particular site. So this fine materials that are deposited at a particular place is known as sediments. And the whole process through which the sedimentary rock is going on, that process, that entire process is known as sedimentation. So here two terms are important. Number one, sediments. Number two, sedimentation. Sediments means the finer particles. And sedimentation means the entire process through which the sedimentary rock is going to form. So this is the basic information of this sedimentation and sediment. Now, through the sedimentation process, when the sediments are deposited, after a certain period of time, that sediment will be hardened and they will form a rock structure. That rock structure is known as sedimentary rock. Okay? So these sediments can come from igneous rock and metamorphic rock and so on. That's what the sedimentary rock, this is also known as secondary rock, because the rock's particles are coming or deriving from igneous rock or any other rock, right? So this is all about the sedimentary rock. Now, if you will look into the examples, there you can find so many outstanding examples are there, like number one, limestone, number two, sandstone. In our school, generally we use the chalk, right? So chalk itself is, it is a calcareous matter. So that is also one sedimentary rock, right? Now, the formation. How does the sedimentary rock forms? What is the process? See here, it is very easy. Just you need to learn this step by step. First, the sediment, it is deposited layer after layer. So when the new layers are deposited, the underlying old layers, it will obviously experience deeper burial. So under the increasing pressure imposed by the overlying load, the water is excluded from the sediment. So by this process, what we can understand that when the layers are depositing or sediments are depositing in layer wise, then obviously the bottommost layer, it will get or it will experience much more pressure than the new one, right? So like this, when the lowermost or the bottommost layer will get more pressure, then what will happen? From there, the water will be excluded. And when the water will be excluded, then suddenly that layer will be more dense and harder. And like this, it will form one solid and hard rock base that is known as sedimentary rock. Okay? And here another important term is present, that is lithification. So what is basically the lithification? The process of turning the sediment into hard rock layers. So see here, the process by which the sediments, they are turning or converting into hard rock, that process is known as lithification. So this is all about the general information of sedimentary rock. Now next is the characteristics. So one by one, let's understand the characteristics. Number one, sedimentary rocks are much more softer than the igneous and metamorphic rocks. Yes, it is true. Like limestone, chalk, you can easily break it, right? But granite, basalt, you cannot break it easily. Number two, unlike igneous rocks, the sedimentary rocks do not have any crystals. Done? Then the sedimentary rocks are pervious. Pervious means you can find so many gaps in these sedimentary rocks, or pores you can find. Through the pores, the water can easily be percolated, or water can easily pass. Next is the sedimentary rocks have the fossils. Fossils means the dead plants and animal bodies. When the layers are depositing, when the sediments are depositing, what happens? The plants and animal bodies are also getting embedded into this. Okay, that's what we can find, some element of dead plants and animals, that is known as fossils. And last but not the least, all the sedimentary rocks are formed in layers or strata. That means sediments are depositing layer wise, one by another. Okay, one over another. So these are depositing layer wise. That's what the sedimentary rock, this is also known as stratified rock. So this is all about the characteristics of sedimentary rocks. Now next one is the economic importance. What is the important things? As I told you, the sedimentary rocks, these are much more softer than igneous rock. So it can be easily used in building purposes. Sedimentary rocks can give us the idea of our past geological time period. Number three, sedimentary rocks have the pervious matter, or it is porous in nature. So inside this rock, we can get the water, oil, etc. So this is all about the sedimentary rock, the characteristics and the economic importance. I hope you have understood this. In a very simple word, I have elaborated this topic. And in the next class, I am going to discuss the several types of sedimentary rocks. Till then, thank you and take care.